Welcome to the module on fermentation milk products curd, buttermilk and cheese under the paper 6 food biotechnology. Today this module deals with a variety of fermentation milk products like curd, buttermilk and cheese. In this module we will be introduced to the technologies used to prepare these fermented dairy products and their functional role in daily life. Now let us see an overview of what we are going to do in this module. As you are already aware, this module is a part of food biotechnology paper. It is designed to give an overview of various milk products. Here you will be able to understand the preparation of these products using fermentation techniques. Also you will be able to learn the techniques in preparing the fermented dairy products, their characteristics and functional roles. Now let us know what is fermentation. Fermentation, as we all know, it is a metabolic process which converts sugars to acids, gases or alcohol. This process, you should know, it mainly occurs in yeast and bacteria. However, it may also take place in oxygen-starved muscle cells, as in the case of lactic acid fermentation. Fermentation is again is a process which cells grow anaerobically. It can be able to generate ATP. Thus fermentation is defined as breakdown of glucose or other sugars in which terminal hydrogen acceptor is an organic molecule. During the breakdown of glucose, we should know glycolysis. Glycolysis is one of the pathways where the glucose is utilized and it is converted to energy. It takes place in the cytoplasm of cell, and this glycolysis is a part of fermentation. This glucose in glycolysis, excess hydrogen atoms are generated somewhere. In lactic acid bacteria, they dump excess hydrogen onto pyruvic acid, the end product of glucose. The lactic acid bacteria is said to be one of the anaerobic bacteria catalyzing this process. This bacteria in turn converts pyruvic acid to lactic acid. In all fermentation, NADH, which is a cofactor, nicotinamide, adenine, dinucleotide, reduced dinucleotide, gives up its hydrogen to produce oxidized form of NAD, nicotinamide, adenine dinucleotide, which is required for further glycolysis. Yeast too performs fermentation, but with different terminal hydrogen acceptors. Example, acetaldehyde, and it also produces products such as carbon dioxide and ethanol. How we are going to apply this fermentation in food processing means? In food processing, this process means the conversion of carbohydrates to alcohols and carbon dioxide or organic acid using yeast, bacteria or a combination of both in under anaerobic condition. This process fermentation exists since time immemorial and must have been existence over before humans managed upon it. The primary and very important benefit of fermentation is the conversion of sugar such as glucose and other carbohydrate into preservative organic acid. That is, where you can convert juice into wine, grains into beer, carbon dioxide to liver bread and sugar in vegetables. Now we should know what are the purpose served by fermentation of food. Actually, fermentation of food serves 5 important purposes. Number 1, enrichment of the diet through development of a diversity of flavor, aromas, texture in food substrate. Number 2, preservation of food through production of lactic acid, alcohol, acetic acid and alkaline fermentation. Number 3, biological enrichment of food substrate with protein, essential amino acids and vitamins. Essential amino acids are those amino acids which cannot be synthesized in our body and it should be supplied from our diet. Number 4, elimination of anti-nutritional factors, decreasing cooking time and fuel requirement. Now let us look at the first topic of today's module, fermentation of milk. Milk, which is a vital to our daily life, which we take daily, because milk contains more amount of calcium and lactose, and this calcium is very important for our bones, and lactose, as it is one of the important carbohydrate, and this milk can be fermented by inoculation of fresh milk with appropriate bacteria and placing it at temperature that favor bacterial growth. At the end of the incubation, milk sugar, the lactose, which is the chief sugar present in milk, is converted to lactic acid, which can be experienced by a tart or sour taste. The reason behind is that the lower pH, which is caused by the presence of lactic acid, preserves the milk by preventing the growth of putrid-active bacteria that do not grow under acidic condition. Now let us see how we can prepare fermented milk products. As I already told you that the fermented milk products are mainly curd, butter and yogurt. Fermented milk products, as it is prepared from milk of almost all domesticated animals since ages. This traditional fermentation usually occurs as a result of activities of natural microbial flora present in the food or added from the surroundings. Among the bacteria, the most important group carrying out for the fermentation is lactic acid bacteria, which I told you earlier, which are generally regarded as safe for human consumption. Fermented milk products, also called as cultured milk products, because we are culturing the bacteria in milk, so we are calling as cultured milk products. They are dairy foods that have been fermented with lactic acid bacteria. This is the only bacteria we are using for our milk fermentation. This fermentation process increases the shelf life. Shelf life means keeping time, or how long you can store milk for prolonged period of time, shelf life of the product, while enhancing the taste and improving the digestibility of milk. We should know what are the most important lactic acid bacterial group. They include lactobacillus, lactococcus and leucinostoc. The term cultured milk, I told you earlier, they are used to designate fermented milks that are prepared by using starter culture and predefined temperature. During fermentation, certain physical and chemical changes occurring in milk as a result of growth and fermentative activities of lactic acid bacteria used as a starter culture. The cultured milk products are produced by making use of specific lactic acid bacterial culture. You should be able to discriminate many types of lactic acid bacteria. We are going to discuss into two broad categories. Number one, those made with use of lactic acid bacteria that grow well at ambient temperature, that is 25 to 30 degrees. They are known as mesophilic starter culture because they require a very warm temperature, not too high or not too cold, that 25 to 30 degrees, they are mesophilic bacteria. Number two, you can also use the lactic acid bacteria that grow well under warm condition, 38 to 45 degrees centigrade, which are known as thermophilic starter culture, which requires a very high temperature. Now, depending upon the type of culture used, the cultured dairy products will vary in their flavor, texture and consistency, and we categorize as follows. Now we are going to categorize according to the texture, flavor. Okay. Number one, products made used by use of mesophilic lactic starter culture, they may use any one of the following starter culture types. Now the first one is O type. Why we are calling this as O type? Because these are starter culture which uses Lactococcus lactis subspecies lactis and Lactococcus lactis subperimoris. These produce only lactic acid as homofermentative. Homofermentative means they produce only lactic acid. Homo means of uniform type. The next category is D type. They include starter culture which contain, in addition to the O type bacteria, also a flavor producing lactic acid bacteria known as Streptococcus lactic, subspecies lactis, Verdeo aceti lactis. As the name implies, it produces a flavor compound known as diacetyl cream butter or buttermilk. The flavor of this particular product is mainly due to the presence of diacetyl. The third category which we are going to take now is L type. This type of starter culture contains, in addition to the O type bacteria, also Leuconostoc mesenteroides, subspecies mesenteroides is the main compound producing bacteria. It produces diacetyl, acetic acid and other flavor producing compounds. Now we go to the fourth type of category, which is a mixed type, which is LD type. These starter culture contain a combination of Streptococcus lactis, subspecies lactis, Verdia lactis and Leuconostoc mesenteroids, subspecies mesenteroids, to give a blend of improved flavor and aroma. So when you combine two different bacteria, you get the additive properties or additive characters of two different bacteria. So you have a milk product of improved flavor of aroma, which is of more commercial use. Now we come into the second products using thermophilic starter culture. We are going to see the products which is made use of thermophilic starter culture. The main product of this group is curd, which we say as Indian dahi. A typical lactic acid bacteria in yogurt starter culture are Streptococcus salivaricus, subspecies thermophili, and Lactobacillus delbrueckii subspecies bulgaricus. The former is responsible for fermenting lactose to lactic acid, whereas delbrueckii subspecies bulgaricus is responsible for flavor production, mainly in the form of acetaldehyde. Some special curd starter cultures use Lactobacillus acidophilus, which produces a natural antibiotic acidophilin, and Bifidobacterium, which are a part of natural bacterial flora of the human gut. The production of this antibiotic is helpful in a way that it will not allow the growth of other bacteria. The only bacteria which will be growing in your product will be your the main bacteria. The primary benefit of using cultured milk is that in people with lactose intolerance, they will not be able to tolerate lactose. They are defecting in the enzyme lactase. So we should know that lactase is the enzyme which breaks down to glucose. Lactose, we all know, it is a disaccharide. So when it is broken down by lactase, it is broken degraded to glucose and galactose. So these people, since they lack lactase, they will not be able to utilize lactase, because they will not be able to convert glucose to galactose. So further consumption of cultured milk does not pose any problem, because a larger part of the milk sugar has already been digested for them by lactic acid bacteria. So in people even having lactose intolerance, you will not have to worry about it, because this lactose is already broken in when you take milk. Lactose is already broken down by lactose, glucose and galactose, even though in the absence of lactase. The production of cultured milk products begin with the good quality milk and a good starter culture, which is seen in the figure. You can see, note down the figure. The milk first, as you see in the figure, the milk is first subjected to filtration to remove physical dirt. That is the first step you have to take. This is followed by pasteurization of milk at 80 to 85 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes in a boiling pasteurizer of a 50 liter capacity. Pasteurization is nothing new which you have been seeing here. It is a process where you are, it is mainly used for milk. It is where you are heating the milk at a very high temperature in a particular equipment, pasteurizer, so that you don't allow the growth of microorganism. Pasteurization of milk will be make the milk very sterile, and you can consume it as such. Once the pasteurization is complete, the milk should be cooled to 20 to 25 degrees centigrade, either in a cold water basin or in a trough. The next step, then the milk is inoculated with 2 to 3% active starter culture, stirred well for 3 to 5 minutes to ensure uniform distribution of starter culture. And then the milk is finally incubated at ambient temperature, that is room temperature, overnight for almost 16 to 18 hours. During the production, care should be taken for intact coagulation. How you can achieve this? By cooling the coagulants before stirring or breaking the curd. As a result, what is the benefit you are getting? They improve the viscosity and consistency of the product. Now let us turn on to the what are the different characteristics of an ideal starter culture which you are going to use for your fermentation of milk. The first and foremost point is that it should be quick and steady in lactic acid production. Number two, it should produce product with fine and clear lactic flavor. Number three, it should not produce any pigments, gas, off flavor and bitterness in the finished products. Number four, it should be associative in nature in product development. Now let us turn our highlight on the role of starter culture in fermented milk. As you all know, when starter culture grow in milk, it affects the constituents of milk and brings fermentative metabolic changes. It produces different intermediary or end products which gives typical characteristic to fermented milk, such as number one, it produces lactic acid. Number two, it brings about coagulation of protein and foam gel. Number three, it produces volatile flavor compounds like diacetyl, acetaldehyde and several intermediate compounds. Number four, it possesses other compounds like carbon dioxide, alcohol, propionic acid, which are essential in products like cheese. Number five, it controls the growth of pathogens and spoilage organism. Number six, some dietary cultures like lactobacillus acidophiles have health benefits and produces antibacterial substances. The last benefit characteristic is it helps in texturing and ripening of milk. Now let us go to the next milk product is curd, as we all say as Indian dahi in Hindi. Curd is a mixture of milk and cream which is fermented by a culture of lactic acid producing bacteria Lactobacillus bulgaricus and Streptococcus thermophilus. In addition, other bacteria may also be added to the culture. Sweetness, example sugar, honey and aspartame. Aspartame is mainly given as a sweetener for diabetes patient. It usually contains the amount of glucose which is beneficial for diabetes. Flavorings like vanilla, coffee and other ingredients like fruits, preservatives, stabilizers such as gelatin, it can also be added. Yogurt contain, in foreign countries they say as yogurt, yogurt contain at least 3.25% milk fat and 8.25% solid non-fat. The consistency, flavor and aroma vary from one region to another. The basic and manufacturing process are consistent. Yogurt is strictly defined as a milk product produced by the action of two bacteria. We already came across this bacteria previously. Streptococcus thermophilus and Lactobacillus delbrueckii for improving its therapeutic significance. Although milk of various animals have been used for curd product in various parts of the world, the most preferred is cow's milk. In India, cow is usually taken as a very religious, and we get more amount of milk we are getting from cow, and we also used to worship cow in India. So it is very suited to our Indian continent. In order to ensure the development of the curd Indian dahi culture, the following criteria for the raw milk must be met. You have to meet out these criteria. Number one, it should have a low bacterial content to avoid any contamination. It should be free from antibiotics, sanitizing chemicals, colostrums and rancid milk. No contamination by bacteriophages virus. And the most important starter culture for most curd production is a symbiotic blend of two bacteria. Symbiosis, as you all would be read in your microbiology, that when they have two organisms, each of the two organisms get benefited by each other. They are symbiotic. Here the two bacteria which is getting benefited is Streptococcus salivarius subspecies, which I am going to use for the module as ST throughout, and Lactobacillus delbrueckii subspecies bulgaricus as LB. Both of them grow independently, however, the rate of acid production is higher when used together than either of the two organisms which is grown individually. Comparatively, ST grows faster and produces both carbon dioxide, which stimulates LB growth. On the other hand, prokaryotic activity of LB produces stimulatory peptides and amino acids for use by ST. So both are benefited by each other. Hence, these microorganisms are ultimately responsible for the formation of typical yogurt flavor and texture. The curd Indian dahi mixture coagulates during fermentation. It is due to drop in pH. The initial drop in pH of yogurt mix to approximately 3 is due to the presence of streptococci. The further decrease to pH 4 may be due to lactobacilli. The products which contribute to flavor of curd are number 1 lactic acid, acetaldehyde, acetic acid and diacetyl. Curd is produced through fermentation of milk by lactic acid bacteria. How we are going to produce this curd? First, the milk should be treated, homogenized, and it should be cooled to allow the addition of bacteria as starter culture. This process is being given in the figure which you are seeing now. At approximate temperature and moisture, the bacteria are able to ferment the lactose into lactic acid. The milk protein, which is the casein, as you all know, the protein present in milk, then coagulate and set to form curd. So casein has also got some due role in curd formation apart from lactose. A colorless liquid called acetaldehyde is also produced during fermentation, contributing to the flavor of curd. Fermenting milk with different microorganisms have also provided an opportunity to develop a wide range of products with different flavors, textures, consistencies and recently health attributes. These include number 1 live curd, which contains bacteria that are harmless but still present and alive, more like probiotic and prebiotics. Probiotic curd, which contain live probiotic microorganisms that are suggested to beneficial to health. You have more probiotic bacteria in your intestine which is helping in digestion, like that you may also think like that. Bio yogurts, which are very popular, are made using a different bacteria, Bifidobacterium bifidium, shortly Bifidobacteria, and are Lactobacillus acidophilus. Bio curd has a milder, creamier flavor which aids in digestion and promotes good health. Last, now we are going to see about how to prepare buttermilk. As a South Indian, many of us know about what is buttermilk. We are routinely taking in our food. Buttermilk is almost a main component of your diet. It is mainly useful during summer. It will be useful for decreasing your heat. It is preferred drink during buttermilk rather than any other cool drinks. Buttermilk is a liquid left behind after churning butter crown out of cream. It also refers to a range of fermented milk drinks. This fermented dairy product, also known as cultured buttermilk because they have a bacteria in them, is produced from cow's milk, which has a characteristic sour taste caused by lactic acid bacteria. It is made using one of two species of bacteria, either Lactococcus lactis or Lactobacillus bulgaris, which creates more tartness. The tartness of buttermilk is due to acidity in the milk. More amount of lactic acid is present in buttermilk rather than any other fermented milk products. The acidity is primarily due to lactic acid produced by lactic acid bacteria while fermenting lactose. As the bacteria produces lactic acid, the pH of the milk decreases and the casein, the principal milk protein, as I told you earlier, coagulates, causing the curdling of the milk. This process makes buttermilk thicker than the plain milk. That's what you are finding, a thick consistency in buttermilk rather than your plain milk. The cultured buttermilk appears to be more viscous than the traditional buttermilk as it contains more lactic acid. Buttermilk prepared in this traditional way is considered beneficial to health as it contains many probiotic microbes. The probiotic nature of buttermilk is said to be beneficial to the gut and improves immunity when taken regularly. Buttermilk contains many compounds, as you all know. It contains many vitamins needed for your body: potassium, calcium, and traces of phosphorus. It is a favorite traditional milk during summer, I told you earlier, as it is soothing to the stomach and alleviates any minor stomach upsets. It gives a very coolant effect when you take buttermilk. That's what everybody prefers, to take buttermilk during summer. In India, flavoring ingredients such as asafoetida, coriander leaves, ginger, curry leaves and salt are mixed with buttermilk to enhance its digestion aiding property. Now moreover, that these components also give more flavor, which will lure the person to take buttermilk. Then we'll see cheese. What is cheese? You should know about cheese more than me. Cheese is a food derived from milk, which is produced in a wide range of flavors, textures, and forms by coagulation of the milk protein casein. It comprises proteins and fat from milk, usually milk of cows. Not only that, you can also you take milk from buffalo, goats, or sheep. During production, the milk is usually acidified and adding the enzyme rennet. Rennet is an enzyme which coagulates the milk. It causes coagulation. Hundreds of types of cheese from various countries were known. They differ in their styles, texture, flavor depending upon the origin of milk, whether they have been pasteurized, the butter fat content, the bacteria and mold, the processing and aging. In cheese, the milk is curdled by adding acids such as vinegar or lemon juice. Most cheeses are acidified to a lesser degree by bacteria, which in turn causes milk sugar to lactic acid, and then the addition of rennet, the enzyme, completes the curdling. Cheese is classified as both hard cheese and soft cheese depending upon the moisture content and whether they are ripened by bacteria or molds or they are unripened. During the preparation of cheese, the whole milk is pasteurized, which is then brought to a temperature of 31 degrees centigrade, followed by the addition of lactic acid producing starter culture and required coloring matter. After about 30 minutes to the mildly acidic milk, rennet solution is then added, stirred, allowed to set the curd for 30 minutes. As in the figure, we should know that the curd, which is set into a very solid mass, is then cut into small, small cubes, which is then heated to 38 degrees apt for that heating for about 45 minutes. What happens to this heating? This heating squeezes whey, is another whey protein, is another component coming out of milk. It squeezes whey from cubes, which is then drained off, so it becomes totally solid. In addition, heat increases the rate of acid production, which makes the curd cubes shrink. Now, the curd is then allowed to mat. The mat is then subjected to the process of cheddaring. Cheddaring, it is mainly done in dairy industry. You may go to any dairy industry, you may be seeing all this process in detail, where the matted curd is cut into block and piling them on one another. This is then allowed by the addition of salt, preserving and ripening to make cheese. Now, to conclude this module, I know that you have learned the fermentation of milk and manufacturing of fermented milk products like curd, buttermilk and cheese. This method involves the use of microbes as starter culture to facilitate the process. These microorganisms, mainly of lactic acid bacteria, are responsible for the conversion of lactose in milk to lactic acid, which may in turn lower the pH of the product, harmful for the growth of other milk spoiling microorganisms. Other milk minor products like diacetyl acetaldehyde producing fermentation imparts other characteristics to the milk, such as color, flavor, texture to the fermented milk products. I hope this module will really benefit you so that you can just visit any dairy industry and just get a practical exposure to the production of fermented milk products. Now, the subsequent module will highlight on the preparation of fermented fish and meat products. Get ready to take up that module. Thank you very much.